The sanctified life, meekness, a fruit of the Spirit. The most precious fruit of sanctification is the grace of meekness. When this grace presides in the soul, the disposition is molded by its influence. There is a continual waiting upon God and a submission of the will to His. The understanding grasps every divine truth, and the will bows to every divine precept without doubting or murmuring. True meekness softens and subdues the heart and gives the mind a fitness for the engrafted word. It brings the thoughts into obedience to Jesus Christ. It opens the heart to the word of God as Lydia's was opened. It places us with Mary as learners at the feet of Jesus. The meek will he guide in judgment, and the meek will he teach his way. Psalm 25, verse 9. The language of the meek is never that of boasting. Like the child Samuel, they pray, "Speak, Lord, for thy servant heareth." 1 Samuel 3, verse 9. When Joshua was placed in the highest position of honor, as commander of Israel, he bade defiance to all the enemies of God. His heart was filled with noble thoughts of his great mission. Yet upon the intimation of a message from heaven, he placed himself in the position of a little child to be directed. "What saith my Lord unto his servant?" Joshua 5 verse 14 was his response. The first words of Paul after Christ was revealed to him were, "Lord, what wilt thou have me to do?" Acts chapter 9 verse 6. Meekness in the school of Christ is one of the marked fruits of the Spirit. It is a grace wrought by the Holy Spirit as a sanctifier and enables its possessor at all times to control a rash and impetuous temper. When the grace of meekness is cherished by those who are naturally sour and hasty in disposition, they will put forth the most earnest efforts to subdue their unhappy temper. Every day they will gain self-control until that which is unlovely and unlike Jesus is conquered. They become assimilated to the divine pattern until they can obey the inspired injunction, "Be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath." James chapter 1 verse 19. When a man professes to be sanctified, and yet in words and works may be represented by the impure fountain sending forth its bitter waters, we may safely say that man is deceived. He needs to learn the very alphabet of what constitutes the life of a Christian. Some who profess to be servants of Christ have so long cherished the demon of unkindness that they seem to love the unhallowed element and to take pleasure in speaking words that displease and irritate. These men must be converted before Christ will acknowledge them as his children. Meekness is the inward adorning which God estimates as of great price. The apostle speaks of this as more excellent and valuable than gold or pearls or costly array. While the outward adorning beautifies only the mortal body, the ornament of meekness adorns the soul and connects finite men with the infinite God. This is the ornament of God's own choice. He who garnished the heavens with the orbs of light has by the same Spirit promised that he will beautify the meek with salvation. Psalm 149 verse 4. Angels of heaven will register as best adorned those who put on the Lord Jesus Christ and walk with him in meekness and lowliness of mind. There are high attainments for the Christian. He may ever be rising to higher attainments. John had an elevated idea of the privilege of a Christian. He says, "Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God." 1 John 3, verse 1. It is not possible for humanity to rise to a higher dignity than is here implied. To man is granted the privilege of becoming an heir of God and a joint heir with Christ. To those who have been thus exalted are unfolded the unsearchable riches of Christ, which are of a thousandfold more value than the wealth of the world. Thus, through the merits of Jesus Christ, finite man is elevated to fellowship with God and with his dear Son. The Sanctified Life, Chapter 1, True and False Theories Contrasted.